Hi everyone, this is the channel with 100x zoom. In this video, I would like to show you how to repair binoculars by yourself. On my channel, the majority of the videos are in Ukrainian, since I am from Ukraine and it is my native language. Yet, as viewers from other nations watch my channel, I'll endeavor to record videos in English to cater to a wider audience. Today, I will be repairing this Japanese binocular. It is extremely similar to this Japanese binocular here, in terms of design and functionality. This one has already been checked. Just see, they are almost identical. This binocular is 10x50, this one is 20x50. However, in essence, they are identical. They differ solely in their eyepieces, or more precisely, the lenses inside. Binoculars of this type are also widespread. Here are smaller AX30 binoculars. This binocular is made by Carl Zeiss. There are various types of boots, such as Green Cat, Tasco, and numerous others of this kind. In essence, they differ solely in size. Additionally, there are Carl Zeiss 10x50 binoculars. Here's the plan. However, fundamentally, they are nearly identical. And there are binoculars like this. They have variable magnification. This binocular has a magnification range from 6 to 18, and this binocular already has some difference from the previous ones. However, fundamentally, this part is the same in all of them. The only difference is in the eyepieces, which have an additional lens that moves like this. Repairing these binoculars is much more difficult, as there are many more details here. In Vinoplim there are, this place has gears that can tilt. They need to be disassembled, cleaned. Also, this mechanism in the left or right eyepiece may tilt when you adjust the magnification. Repairing such binoculars is more difficult, and if you are a beginner in this, I do not recommend you to attempt repairing these binoculars. And in general, this variable magnification system is quite unreliable, and modern binoculars, mostly Chinese ones, which are very cheap. They lack gears, having only a metal plate that often breaks and is prone to damage and frequent fractures. I generally advise against buying them. There are also binoculars, mostly modern ones, with roof prisms. To repair them, in most cases, you need to cut through this rubber coating and remove it, and then unscrew the binoculars. They are somewhat difficult to repair. You can check out my other videos where I demonstrated how this can be done at home. I possess an individual video where I demonstrated the tools I utilize for the purpose of repairs and maintenance. The link will be in the description below the video, but mostly I use this kind of tool. Similar to this, a tool called pliers, a small number of tools called screwdrivers, and this particular kind of alcohol. Sometimes I use this alcohol, sometimes I use isopropyl alcohol. If you have regular alcohol at home, you can also use it. If your binoculars have been lying in a closet for 10 or 20 years, in a closed room, it's likely that fungus has appeared inside, and in order to bring it back to normal, in order for you to be able to look through the binoculars once more, and the optics were clean, you must completely disassemble it initially. After you fully disassemble and reassemble it, you will need to make adjustments to fit your own eyes in order to prevent the binoculars from causing double vision. A separate video demonstrating all types of adjustments will be linked in the description below the video. Now let's start. First, you need to unscrew these lenses here. Following that, utilizing a key such as this one, you will need to unscrew the clamping ring by turning it in a counterclockwise direction in order to proceed with the task at hand. We eliminate the body with the lens, and in certain situations, the lens can be promptly eliminated in this direction. In some binoculars, you also need to unscrew another ring, a clamping ring, from the other side, and extract the lens from its position by carefully removing it. To avoid scratching the surface, it's better to place them on a cloth. How do I remove these glasses? They can be removed separately, first this one, then this one. We need to unscrew this one first, in the middle. The majority of binoculars are typically equipped with a counter screw in this particular location, for convenient adjustment purposes. Very small, it also needs to be unscrewed. And then, as an illustration, take such a tool and proceed to unscrew the central screw using the appropriate screwdriver or wrench, depending on the type of screw head, until it is completely removed. Subsequent to that, we proceed to lift up the right lens and the left lens, engaging in the repair of the glasses, or more precisely, carrying out the necessary repairs on them. Cleaning can occasionally be challenging, so you need to thoroughly inspect, particularly in this area on the exterior, and wipe with a clean cloth. And in the event that the eyepiece appears clean to you, it is advisable not to make any contact with it. If it is dirty, you will need to unscrew it at this location, remove all of the lenses, clean them, and then put them back in the exact same order. How to do this? I have a plethora of diverse videos on my channel. You can see all of them. If you are unable to unscrew these parts manually, you have the option of utilizing a wrench similar to this one. And then unscrew. This Japanese binocular is approximately 70-80 years old. Its optics are almost clear. However, I still made the decision to thoroughly clean it in order to improve the image quality. The prisms possess a single layer coating. In order to remove the prism, it is necessary to unscrew the clamping spring. In order to retrieve the prism, I utilize a pair of tweezers. In this spot, the prism has a slight chip. It will not affect the image in any way. There are clearly noticeable traces of fungus. Prior to cleaning the prism, I first rinse it thoroughly under a steady flow of running water to ensure proper cleaning. To rinse off solid particles that have the potential to scratch the optics. I merely apply drops of alcohol to water and commence wiping by utilizing either soft cloths or specialized ones that are extremely soft in order to prevent any potential damage to the delicate glass surface. This is how I managed to clean the prism. Now the same needs to be done with the other three that are still here. You can also treat the inside of the binoculars with alcohol to remove any dirt or smudges. Alcohol has never harmed anyone. The more you consume, the better it is. So, examine the situation from that perspective and see for yourself. Four prisms have been cleaned and lenses. Now I commence to reassemble everything back into the binocular housing structure. Now examine the optimal sequence of steps for putting together binoculars. First of all, you need to place these prisms, the first and the second one, then screw in the objective with the lens, with the housing, and then blow from this side. And after that, proceed to install an extra prism in this particular location. I have already installed the prisms closest to the eyepiece. Next, we cover them with prism covers. And we fasten it in this location. As you can see, I have almost fully assembled the binoculars. I completely recovered it, cleaned them, didn't touch the eyepieces. The lenses in them are quite clean. I adjusted these binoculars using the adjustment rings on the objectives.